Our next match is Oleg versus David. From Ukraine, he is 29 years of age, 6 foot tall, and 185 pounds. Ladies and gentlemen, Oleg Zhok!
Oleg. Absolute legend of the sport, Oleg Zhok, for the man from Ukraine. Many people consider him to be the pound-for-pound best left-arm arm wrestler ever seen alive. Let's see what he brings tonight.
And his opponent from Armenia. He is 24 years of age. 6 foot one and 225 pounds. Ladies and gentlemen, David Dadakon.
David Dadakon looks unreal. This dude might be the most shredded guy here. Super high pedigree. Really excited to see this match left-handed. I know this guy has given trouble to the best of the best.
Yeah, of course, the training partner with Denis Saplankov as well. So when we talk about preparations for Oleg Zhok, of course, Oleg Zhok has one of the biggest, most difficult hands to deal with. But David trains with Denis Saplankov, the other man in the arm wrestling world who has an enormous hand. This is a great match. This is a return match for Oleg Zhok, as we said. One of the greatest pound-for-pound left-arm arm wrestlers of all time. Of course, in 2018, he had a motor vehicle accident that put him out of the sport for some time. He's on the charge back. He's the 80-kilo world champ again. Let's see if he can hang with someone of the quality of David Samashuya at 100 kilos.
Shoulders, knuckles, open. Jok, knuckle. The both knuckles. Don't climb, Jok.
So awesome to see Oleg on the stage. Killing it, man. This dude's great.
So in terms of stylistic approaches here, you've got Oleg Zhok, who is the all-out top roller. He's got such a big hand, he's pronated, almost looks like two forearms in one. David, on the other hand, he is a specialist hook puller, very explosive, wrist flexion based, which is a very interesting contrast of styles between these two guys.
I mean, Oleg's been dealing with hook pullers for so long. I mean, that's like his specialty. You try to hook Oleg, your wrist gets busted back traditionally.
So interesting looking outside of straps here. Stop. David is threatening Oleg out of straps. He's not showing any, he's not intimidated at all by the back pressure. He's saying, I'm coming right at you. I don't even need a strap. Right now, I feel like Oleg would be nervous.
Yeah, I mean, he definitely has a lot of weapons and a lot of things to throw at Oleg. Getting a bite on the back of Oleg's wrist and stuff like that, we'll see what kind of commitment he's able to get on Oleg's hand. I mean, I know it's a little bit of a different type of hand. I mean, I don't know how comfortable he'll be getting a hold of Oleg, to be honest.
Oh, it's okay.
Let's have a look at where this one goes. Referee's grip now.
Don't climb.
Dadakan on the right of screen. Closed first.
Don't climb. Down.
You see, he looks very calm and solid. Oleg. Yeah, yes. On the other hand, looks like he's a little bit under pressure.
Down. Ready, go!
Speed there from David. Camera angle didn't show, but off to the straps we go. That looked very snappy from Dadakan.
This dude is a warrior. You can tell he's bringing the heat and all of the above to this match. It's going to go the straps right now, which will give David a way better chance of holding onto Oleg and maintaining his wrist pressure. I'm interested to see the straps set up, what he's pushing for while they apply the straps.
Open.
Okay. Now, one of the things about Oleg Zhok and his style of arm wrestling and the particular hand size that he's got, when he gets in the strap, he has a great ability to retract his thumb, and the strap becomes very low on his arm as a result of it. He gets very close and intimate to his opponent, yet has this amazing pronation ability. It's a unique combination amongst arm wrestlers. It's what sets him apart, and it's the tool he will use tonight to attempt a top roll, David.
And this first round is going to tell us so much about how this match will go. Once again, you know, with these contrasting styles, and we've had a few of these matches, it's just first round, such a telltale sign.
from Don't Crime. It's good. Okay.
Strap on Oleg's referee's hand. Grip. It's my round number referee's one. Grip. That will help. You can see very deep grip for both guys here. That David is definitely happy with that. Look for the wrist flexion and the side pressure explosion
my grip.
From Dedekind. Referee's grip.
Straight your shoulder.
David not settled, but shoulder. He looks the stronger man.
Center
he looks
is okay.
in control. Oleg is going to need to flatten out his wrist
don't touch,
to
don't
be in
touch.
This match.
Look at the center is here.
See that shoulder coming
in the middle.
From David. He's already creeping that shoulder. He's going to explode sideways. It looks like
down.
Heavy.
That's massive. It looks dangerous. Oleg Zhok up against the wall. Let's see what he's got.
Zhok, down, Zhok, down.
Super deep grip from both guys.
Straight, straight. Ready, go!
Great start there, Eddie Chips.
Elbow down.
David Dedekind taking the win in round number one. Oleg Zhok acknowledging that one. I feel like David, he got a lot of carve in before the go there. Oleg Zhok, if he's going to play his cards well, I think he needs to talk to the referees, get them all squared up. But David Dedekind, look at that. There's the replay. You can see great initiation, supination, wrist flexion, side pressure. The pronation of Oleg contained and then pinned. Look at him staring into the eyes. Wow, he's a beast.
Man, that dude is explosive and dangerous. So, interested to see when they switch sides, how Oleg's going to utilize different sides of the table. It really means a lot in terms of strap application and what kind of grip you get. So I'm interested to see how Oleg works the opposite side of the table.
There's not many people that have pinned Oleg Zhok's left arm in history. He is one of the most awkward and difficult opponents you'll ever face. His hand is incredibly large, but David, right then, had no fear. He came straight forward. He cut off the pronation, took control. Oleg looked like he had a solid defense. There was definitely strength there, but out of position like that, he was unable to get through. I feel like if Oleg's going to bring this one back, he needs to get a better start position.
David.
Definitely. It looks like he was a little bit supinated into David's wrist. I don't know if that was by any of his own doing or if just the setup and with David's cupping made him supinated into his wrist. But yeah, I definitely want to see him pronate a little bit more up into David's hand, get a more flat wrist to attack David's fingers.
David.
Playing some Led Zeppelin in the background, if I'm not mistaken.
Linkin Park, man, yeah. Led Zeppelin, where are you at?
Pretty sure it's Led Zeppelin.
All right, round number two coming up. David Dedekind in control so far. Looking good. Oleg Zhok going to have to mix something up here. He has the better side of the strap. That will help him in his cause. But right now, David Dedekind looking very powerful, very confident, and in control.
They're both knuckles. Don't cover, okay? Don't cover the knuckle.
Oleg's middle fingers
okay,
are
stop,
so
stop.
Long.
Referee's grip. It's better.
Straight to the referee's grip now. You see, very composed is David Dedekind. He means business. He knows what he's got to get. He's confident that he can do it. It's all the pressure is on Oleg Zhok right now to change what's going on. He needs to control center. David Dedekind at the moment just far too strong from round one. Let's see what adjustments Oleg will bring.
Not like this. Okay, referee's grip.
I've never gripped Oleg, but it looks so interesting, the shape of his hand.
Open, referee's grip. It's my grip. Straight. Rotate.
I've had the opportunity. The first time I ever went to a World Championships, round number one, I got to pull Oleg Zhok.
Okay.
It's incredibly different.
Don't push the center.
The width of his
thumb is
bigger than anyone else's I've ever seen. Very difficult hand to control, but at the moment, it's David Dedekind doing exactly that, controlling the pronation. Of Oleg Zhok. Here we go. Outside of straps, round number two. Stop. Early start there from Oleg Zhok.
Foul. Don't climb.
He's been fouled on that one. No warning. Straight foul.
I mean, top rollers, that those centimeters and those small gains are super important. So I understand him getting a false start. Not trying to get sucked deep into that hook again with David.
Center. Don't push. Okay. Down. Zhok. Down. Straight your wrist. Wrist straight, little bit down. No, let's move. Little bit down. Yeah.
Venice.
Yeah. Ready, go! strap match.
Straight up, big explosive hit there. You can see that Oleg had the wrist tight and the control, but there's so much side pressure and explosivity coming from David that there's no ability to hold on from Oleg Joe.
Yeah, I mean, I think most people, you know, when especially as a top roller, as an offense, most top rollers, it's an offensive move. You want to be the one dictating the match. You want to be the one leading the dance. You want your guy holding onto you while you do what you want, and they try to adjust to you. So I don't think Oleg will ever be in a position where he's trying to hold on a ton, right? People always chase him and try to pursue him. So I think this is a comfortable position for him, but he can't let him get that much of a grip on the back of his hand and that much commitment.
Now Oleg having the good side of the strap this time. It'll be interesting. I hope we get the camera angle from the other side. We'll see what position that Oleg takes. At the moment, it was the carving in from David Dedekhan that was really the telltale factor in round number one. If he can square it up and get more into the hand and wrist, of David, there is a chance. Let's see where this one goes.
Oleg looked like he was driving those knuckles up. From this camera angle I'm seeing, it looks like Oleg's strap is super low, I mean, which will provide a ton more back pressure.
He has that ability to get it low because he can retract his thumb so far with the hand shape that he's got.
Right.
More? It's okay? Okay, reference grip. Jock, down. Down. Yeah, knees.
You can see there the strap position. Have a look at that vertical strap on Oleg Joc. See how it's almost below the wrist joint entirely. That is what historically he takes such good control of, an advantage. He gets amazing back pressure. His wrist flexion becomes immense because of it. And you can see he looks confident. David is the one who looks a little unsettled right now.
Yeah, shoulder. Definitely doesn't seem to have as much purchase in the back of Oleg's hand. He's not as committed forward. I'm looking to see David be explosive here.
Look at the knuckle. Down. Okay. Straight your wrist.
Stop.
I will fix it. Okay, come on.
Oh, who's going to get the warning there? Both guys looking jittery. Oleg Joc, I thought, went first.
Just listen to me. Okay.
But David getting spoken to here. Referee's grip.
Straight your wrist.
Both guys nervous. They know what's on the line.
That ready go looked like it was favoring Oleg, I think.
Down.
Wrist.
Down.
Wrist.
Down.
Wrist.
Rotate. Ready, go!
Oh, my goodness. David Dedekhan is just simply too strong. Oleg Joc had all the setup he needed, but wow.
Dude. So, I mean, what does Oleg do here? I think he had a way better setup that time.
He did.
I do think he's going second. I don't think he's being explosive as he might be able to be, but there's not a ton of adjustments I see for Oleg besides what he's doing.
Yeah, honestly, I feel like Oleg actually did everything right there. He got superior position in the strap relative to what he did in round one. He initiated well, but it was just a wrist flexion from David Dedekhan. He's just simply too good. And once the side pressure became involved, it was one-way traffic. And then once again, you can see David Dedekhan staring down his opponent. He is asserting himself as the dominant arm wrestler tonight.
The score currently 2-0 for David. Man, still excited to see Oleg here on the stage.
Oh, it's amazing seeing him come back. As we said, he's considered the greatest pound-for-pound left-arm arm wrestler of all time. At only 85 kilos, he has beaten people in the past, like Andriy Pushka. He's beaten all bar Denis Saplenkov, I think, on the left arm, essentially. He's got pins on Devin Larratt. He's pins on John Brzezink. He's got pins on just about everyone there is. He's somewhere in his comeback. We've seen him take a world title at 80 kilos once again, so we know that he's already the number one guy at his weight category, but he's attempting to return to his old form by being able to beat super heavyweights. David Dedekhan at the moment too much for him at 100 kilos, the man who trains with Denis Saplenkov, but no doubt Oleg's rise will continue.
David!
David's being so dominant right now. I feel like he still has a few options, a few angles he could work and still pin Oleg. I think he's definitely in the driver's seat. I think that it's up to Oleg to try to do some crazy wild stuff and see what he can pull out.
You can see the back is up against the wall here for Oleg. Crazy wild stuff. I don't know what there is available. There's certainly not a hook available. David Dedekhan is in control of that lane. He's going to have to find a way to get the wrist back, but we haven't seen the wrist go back at all tonight from David Dedekhan. Despite the top roll prowess that Oleg Joc possesses, unable to force it. David Dedekhan's wrist flexion, his commitment to side pressure has just been too good. And right now, David Dedekind only one win away.
I'm looking for Oleg to slip the referees a $20 bill, perhaps $100.
You fix the grip or we'll go in the referees? Are you fixing?
You can see David Dedekind taking that high grip where he's not gripping low because he's after the slip. We saw that lightning fast start from him in the rounds one and two where he gets the slip quite easily.
Center is
the speed that he possesses, the reaction time, Oleg Zok can't hold on to it. And he can't get control out of the strap.
No, it's okay. Center is okay. Yeah. David first. Going down, a little bit down.
Falanga, no falanga. Falanga.
Ready, go! Strap match.
There it is, that explosive top roll once again from both guys there, sending it to the strap, round number three. Oleg Zok up against the wall, David Dedekind in control.
Hook him, Oleg. Throw a wrench in his game plan and hook this man.
Isn't it interesting when you look at the anatomy and that massive forearm that Oleg possesses?
Okay.
I've often wondered myself, how do you have developed as a hook puller? Like, what would he have had with all of that extra musculature that he possesses?
Open, relax.
I have no idea what's going on inside Oleg's arm. To be honest, like, open, to compare open, it to, you know, my arm or your arm, I don't know the connection points there, what's going on. So I don't know if you know, the connection in his bicep and in his the inside of his elbow is as significant as brachial radialis and things like that. His ability to hammer curl, you know. I'd be interested to see if he trained it, you know, full time, what it would look like. Calm before the storm. Oleg looks like, how old is Oleg?
Oleg, let's have a look. Oleg is only 29 years old. So he's still young. He's still got plenty of time in the sport. Of course, he's been all the way to the top, essentially. He's on the way back, so there's still plenty of time to come back. David of Armenia only 24. Open. That's scary.
David is younger than Oleg. Open.
Yeah, wow.
We did not see that coming. All right.
Okay, referee's grip. It's my grip. Straight your shoulder. Little bit down. Rotate the wrist. Center here, a little bit. And this center here. Okay.
See that beautiful setup from David Dedekind again. Close. Great depth. He's got great knuckle height. He's going to control the pronator of Oleg once
center
more.
Center is okay. Don't move.
Look
don't
to
move.
Decisively win.
Ready,
this
go.
Here it goes. There it is, control. Oleg's not giving it his all. David Dedekind wanting the top roll in.
Stop.
Oh my goodness, wow. That's
please,
the referee's calling it something a bit rough there. There is the win. You can see pain in the eyes of Oleg Zok.
You're okay?
Ooh, nasty stuff there to finish that one. Bit of venom.
Yeah, I mean, he came in fired up to execute his game plan, and he did.
Let's have a listen. The referee's just talking with David. The referee's calling a little bit of almost foul play crossing the lines there. You can see the aggression. Watch here. David tried to make a point. He tried the top roll Oleg towards the end, and he actually, Oleg concedes. As you'll see, David gets control, and then after the pin, he pins him again. Thankfully, no injuries occurred or anything, but the referee's cautioning David there, saying, hey, no need for that aggression after. But great match nonetheless, David Dedekind in control. Well, let's cross now to Coach Ray, or very shortly, with your winner.
I am here with the winner, David Dedekind. That was really impressive. We have never seen anything like that to be done versus Oleg Zok. Round of applause. Как ты себя чувствовал? How do you feel?
Я по-русски, если что. А что сказать? Хорошо, все отлично. Готовился нормально. Нечего добавить. Просто хорошая была форма. Желаю Олегу удачи. Он хороший спортсмен. Ничего личного. Просто спорт без обид.
He said he trained really hard for this match. He want to thank Oleg for the match. He believes he's a great athlete. Nothing personal. It was just him being in this moment. What would be the next opponent that you really want to pull? Какой будет, какой соперник ты хотел сам?
Ну, то, что я не буду гонять вес, это точно, спуститься до 100. Либо это будет 110, либо 110 плюс. Готов бороться со всеми, да хоть с Алексом Курдейчем, хоть с Гаспарини, любым, кто скажет энгин. С теми поборемся. Главное, я готов со всеми побороться. Главное, чтобы они были готовы.
So he said most likely he will not cut weight no more to 100 kilos. But today we congratulate him as the 100 kilo left arm East versus West champion. One more round of applause. And he said he's ready to fight any 110, 110 kilo plus. Doesn't matter if it's Kurdecha or Gasparini or anyone. One more time, David Dadikyan.